Yes, it was big, big news for hockey fans in Seattle. They officially will be the proud owners of a 32nd NHL franchise. They'll start playing in the 2021-22 season. They'll play in the Pacific Division. In case you missed any of this info on the day the announcement was made, the Coyotes move to the Central when that happens, and the expansion draft will happen in June of 2021. And of course, Nick Costonika was on the scene for this big news, this monumental news for the National Hockey League. He joins us now. Nick, you spent 9 days and eight nights in Seattle. What was the reaction like from the local people there when Seattle was awarded their team?
Well, it's rough duty for me to have to go to Henry's Tavern at 9 a.m. on a Tuesday and hang out with all these people. And, you know, Seattle has a relatively small hockey community, but it's strong and it's passionate. And they packed this bar looking up at screens, and it was really cool. It was really, you know, there was a buzz in the air, and then it goes silent when Commissioner Bettman starts talking. And as soon as he said the word Seattle, they erupted in cheers, and it was a great moment. It was watching history.
Tod Leiweke has been a huge part of bringing the NHL back to Seattle, Nick. Why should people be excited about this group in Seattle and with Tod Leiweke running the show here?
Well, I don't think you could ask for better leadership than what they have in Seattle. You've got a guy with vast experience who's got a passion for hockey and a love for this city. I mean, this is the guy who was president of the Minnesota Wild when they came into the National Hockey League. He went to the Seattle Seahawks, turned them around. He launched the Seattle Sounders, so he's already launched two expansion teams, one in Seattle. Then he goes to the Tampa Bay Lightning and helps them become a world-class franchise. He left the job of NFL COO to take over this project, and he's working with his brother Tim, who used to be CEO of the parent companies of the LA Kings and the Toronto Maple Leafs. So you've got incredible leadership here. This is a guy who grew up in St. Louis playing hockey, played hockey when he was president of the Seahawks. He's got a history of connecting his teams to the community, creating a sense of place and authenticity everywhere he goes. So I think there's a lot to be excited about for the direction this franchise is headed.
Nick, tell us what's next on the hockey side. Obviously, you would have got a chance to spend a great deal of time with a guy like Dave Tippet, their only hockey employee technically at this stage. What do you see happening in the near future here as far as what type of housekeeping they have to get done?
Well, I asked Tip directly. I said, do you want to be the coach? He said, no. I said, do you want to be the GM? He said, no. And I know Tod Leiweke asked him the same questions. He's a senior advisor. I would expect him to have some sort of executive title when all said and done. But he's done everything from meet with minor hockey associations, the junior teams in the area, to research an AHL team where that will be a good fit. And what he really loves is designing the team areas in the arena and the training center. This is a guy who flipped houses when he was a player for the Hartford Whalers, who built motorcycles when he was coaching the Dallas Stars. He loves to build, and he's literally building there. He's got blueprints from all over the NHL, from different facilities. He can basically create his dream environment for a coach and for players. And you know what? That will help them recruit a GM. That will help them recruit a coach when the time comes, and he's going to be involved in that process too.
Well, based on what we saw with Vegas last season, I mean, an incredible inaugural season for the Golden Knights. What can Seattle take away from them and what they were able to do, especially, I'm sure, in the expansion draft? I mean, how might this Seattle franchise look to build their organization both on and off the ice?
Well, funny you should mention that, because that was one of Dave Tippett's first duties, was to do a deep dive study of the Vegas Golden Knights, why they succeeded, what they can learn from that. And, you know, I think it's going to be a very hard act to follow. I think to expect Seattle to go to the Stanley Cup final in its first season is going to be very difficult. We all know GMs learn from their experience in the expansion draft. But remember this. This team is coming into a league with a salary cap. It's coming into a league by itself, so it doesn't have to compete with another expansion team for assets. It has the same rules Vegas did. So at minimum, it's going to have a good pool of players to choose from. And I don't think you measure an expansion team just on its first season. I think you're trying to build for the long term. I know Vegas is trying to do that. I know Seattle will try to do that. And they should be competitive. They have a chance to be competitive and build something that's going to last beyond one season.
You have another story coming out on Sunday about the Seattle situation on NHL.com. What can you tell us about that?
Well, I didn't know a whole lot about the Seattle history or the Seattle hockey scene. I knew the trivia question that the Metropolitans were the first U.S. team to win the Stanley Cup, but not much more beyond that. And it was really fun to go out there and visit the site where that Stanley Cup was played in 1917. There's a plaque next to an office building downtown. It was cool to learn the history. I mean, the first sporting event at what became Key Arena was a hockey game in 1964 between the Totems and the Toronto Maple Leafs. I mean, Johnny Bauer played there. Terry Sawchuk played there. Dave Keon, Frank Mihaljevic. The Soviets played there months after the Summit Series. And then they came back a year later and lost with Tretiak in goal. There's a really cool hockey history in Seattle, and there's a strong hockey community. The biggest concern for people in the hockey community is having enough rinks for when there's a surge in interest once this team starts playing.
Nick, I know you just said that Seattle will have the same rules as Vegas, but would you say it's the same opportunity in terms of, obviously, Vegas is exempt from the draft, so they won't have to be forced to lose a player, but they also can end up being kind of a competitive option for teams that may want to move players. So do you think that it's a same or equal type opportunity for Seattle when you consider those two factors?
No, I think that that's clear. It's not the same because George McPhee had the chance to go first. He did a heck of a job. And I think everybody learned from that. And you're right. I think McPhee is going to be able to leverage this himself and because he's exempt, be able to make some trades with teams that have trouble protecting their assets. What I do think, though, is it's still far better than what previous expansion teams had. You still have a better pool of players. You still have a salary cap. There's still going to be teams that want to get rid of contracts that are going to be in tight situations. So I think when all's said and done, it may not be quite as good as Vegas. It's still going to be a heck of a lot better than what expansion teams used to have. And I do think that Seattle will learn some lessons and maybe do some innovative things too.
All right, Nick, well, you spent more than a week out in Seattle. I'm one of many people that is planning to go out there once they have the team. If there's one place I got to go, where is it?
You got to go to the Angry Beaver. It's the only hockey bar in Seattle, and this guy's awesome. He came from Toronto, wanted a place to watch hockey, and created a hockey bar, and it's the coolest place. You walk in there, it's not a Leafs bar or a Canadiens bar. It's a hockey bar. There's jerseys from all over the league. There's Metropolitans jerseys, Totems jerseys, and you walk in there, and there's all these expat hockey fans watching their favorite team. It's a really cool spot, and you know what? You can get poutine, too.
Oh, my gosh. I am so sold. I mean, you had me sold on the hockey, but as a Canadian, the poutine is the thing that pushed me over the edge. I'm so glad I asked that question. Nick, thank you for your time, and we'll talk to you later.
Thank you.